Hey guys, I'm Patrick Hall with F-Stoppers, and for the last 5 to 8 years, fstoppers.com has really become one of the leading educational sites for photographers. Most of the content that we produce on fstoppers.com and on this YouTube channel are really catered towards professional photographers. But we know we have a lot of readers who have maybe never picked up a camera or are brand new to photography. So recently we produced a comprehensive tutorial on all of the basics of photography, everything from how a camera works, how to pick out a lens, how to place your subject in the correct light, and even a little bit of how to use strobe light. Today I want to share a small excerpt from this full-length tutorial so that no matter where you are in your photography journey, you can pick up a camera and be a better photographer.
Let's quickly talk about how a standard DSLR or digital single lens reflex camera works. As you probably know, light enters a camera through the lens. And as you probably know, most lenses have multiple glass elements which can focus the light and beam it on the film, or in this case, the camera sensor, which is located inside the body itself. Now, some lenses are zoom lenses, and if you turn the zoom ring, you're going to be moving certain elements backwards and forwards. That's going to change the magnification of what you're actually capturing on that sensor. Now, there's other elements as well, and of course, all lenses have a focus ring. Moving those around will determine what part of your scene is actually in focus. Do you want to focus on something that's really close to the camera, or do you want to focus on something that's really far away from the camera? That's why focus is very important when it comes to a lens. In the middle of each of these lenses is an aperture, has multiple blades, and it can either open up or stop down, allowing more light to enter or less light to enter. When the aperture is wide open, light is able to enter the lens and hit the sensor from multiple different angles. This creates a shallow depth of field. Your subject might be in focus, but the background will quickly go out of focus. If you stop down that aperture, creating a really, really small opening, now light is only able to enter the lens directly from the front from one direction, and therefore we get a deeper depth of field, meaning that your subject and the background can be more in focus at the exact same time. So now let's talk about why this is called a DSLR, or digital single lens reflex camera. First of all, it's digital because it's a digital camera. We're not shooting on film. It's a single lens camera because we only have one lens on the front of this. There are other types of cameras that have multiple lenses. And then it's a reflex camera because the light enters through the front of the lens, it hits a mirror, bounces up into a prism, and allows me to look through the viewfinder. You'll notice the viewfinder does not go directly through the lens. The viewfinder is up above the lens. But because of this reflex, I'm actually able to look through the lens. So then you may be asking yourself, how am I able to take a picture through a lens while at the same time looking through that lens? And normally you wouldn't be able to, but the mirror actually gets out of the way each time you take a picture. So if I turn this camera on here and I take a shot, you can hear that ch-ch-ch, and a few things are happening. First of all, the mirror is popping up. So if you look through the viewfinder, you'll notice that as you take the picture, it goes black and then comes back. That's because the mirror is popping up. The light then is coming directly through the lens and hitting what would be the sensor in the back, but there's a shutter in the way. The shutter has two separate leaves. So one opens up, revealing the sensor behind it. That begins the exposure and the camera starts to capture the image. And then one more leaf comes behind that, closing off the sensor so that it's not receiving any more light and the exposure is then over. Now, in the past, instead of a photo sensor, we would have had a piece of film back there that was sensitive to light. For this tutorial, we're going to be using digital cameras, and digital cameras have a digital chip, usually a CCD or a CMOS chip, that has photosensitive material on it that allows it to track red, blue, and green colors over the course of many different photo sites. The camera then takes all of this information, breaks it down, creates a file that's made up of millions of individual little pixels that are each its own separate color. And the interesting thing is, if you think about megapixels, that means million pixels. So if you have a 10 megapixel camera, that means that the file that it's actually creating, if it's a JPEG or RAW file, it has 10 million pixels to create that image.
So guys, I hope that lesson was informative and really helped you on your own photographic journey. If you want more information about the full-length tutorial, head over to fstoppers.com/store. And if you want more content on photography, head over to fstoppers.com, where you can find articles every single day.